So, hey family, welcome back. I don't know what to tell you, it happened again. this morning after my cat chores, well, my phone died last night at some point while I was sleeping, so it was completely dead. I had to put it on charge this morning. So I got up and was doing my cat chores and charging my phone up. Then I sat down and was sipping on my coffee, and the next thing I know, the song's in my head. And I turned my phone on. It was exactly 12:30. I captured the screenshot. 12:30 is 3-2-1, and it means lead up, bring up, set sail, which is connected to cruise ships, and that's the Ark and the Ark of Jesus and the days of Noah. It's my big confirmation number. So, I mean, it's the very first thing I've seen, and you can look at the top. It says I only had 25% battery life. So that's why I put that note there. So you could see, you know, the phone was dead. And here's some more timestamps. So immediately after that, I went to find that song with lyrics, so I could see what the Lord's trying to show us. And these particular pictures right here are just for the timestamp. 12:30, 3-2-1, and 12:33. Okay. And then 4-3-2-1 on this one. And you notice it's got 33 million views. And that made me think of Ezekiel 33 to warn the people. And Okay, so the video was exactly 4 minutes long, so I looked up the number 400, and it means to cry out. I call out, I shout, I exclaim. Okay, so here's the thing, family. I've been thinking on this all day and praying, and then I got sidetracked for a little bit because I'm still trying to glean as much as I can about the safe zones and the danger zones for the World War III nuclear exchange concerning the United States. This is where I live, so this is, you know, the country that I have to focus on. I'm sure that God has got people placed in every country who will try to do the same thing for their countries to find safety zones and danger zones. And we've been talking about the war, right? Okay, so I believe we're going to go step by step through this song. I believe there was a personal message in it for me. And I took that also as a personal message for every watch person who has channels and is warning. Okay? Because they're open for attacks. And this was a personal message for you. So if you're a watch person, you know what I mean. This is a personal message for you from our Lord. So let Holy Spirit speak to you. It's also a message for the church. And I believe it even has a message for the left behind as well. Okay, so I'm going to try to break it down the best that I can. And I did get confirmation, not just the 3-2-1. And I'll show you that when we're done. Or tell you that. So there is freedom within, there is freedom without. Try to catch the deluge in a paper cup. We are set free in Jesus, right? There's really not a whole lot to glean from this first verse, but other than we have freedom in Jesus. And this verse here, there's a battle ahead. Many battles are lost, but you'll never see the end of the road while you're traveling with me. This is a message. The Lord is with us. We will never see the end of the road because we're walking with Him. He's walking with us, right? Same for the left behind, same, you know, for believers today and believers tomorrow, right? I think it also has rapture connotations. You'll never see the end of the road, meaning our road is coming, you know, to an end as well. So, and hey now, don't dream, it's over. Hey now, when the world comes in. I believe don't dream, it's over, meaning don't make plans. Planning for the future is kind of worthless at this point, that Jesus is so close to coming. You know, just like that dream that Roche had, where the man in the dream, she said, "What's your plans? What plans are you making this year?" And he said, "I'm not making any plans this year. There's no point. Jesus is coming." And then the same kind of connotation is in this song. Don't dream. It's over. Don't worry about worldly dreams. It's over. It's coming to an end, right? And it also saying when the world comes in, they come to build a wall between us. We know they won't win. The world, the enemy, they come to build a wall between us and our Lord Jesus. We know they won't win. And that, you know, was personal for me. Hey, don't let enemy attacks come between us, me and Jesus. I know and he knows the things he shows me, the things he shares with me, the things I share with you, the warnings, the hope, the encouragement, whatever message it might be. You know, if an attack comes, it's the enemy trying to build a wall between me and my Lord. Okay? And we know, and it's the same for you, we know they won't win. So when they come, no, they're just trying to build a wall between you and the Lord. Now I'm towing my car. There's a hole in the roof. My possessions are causing me suspicion, but there's no proof. I don't know exactly what all to glean from this one, other than trials and tribulations, right? But, you know, everyday life, right? And in the paper today, tales of war and of waste. But you turn right over to the TV page, meaning the war, it's coming. It's coming. But we turn over, right, to the Lord. Our TV page is God's Word. Our TV page is Jesus. We turn to Jesus, right? So it's encouragement, but it's also more confirmation about the war. Okay, family? So, but we know the left behind is the ones really going to suffer. But the left behind, you know, they won't see the end of the road either, as long as they're walking with our Lord Jesus after the rapture. Even if they give their life, they're not ever going to come to the end of the road because they have eternal life, right? So, and watch people, you know, glean this. Don't let the world come in or the enemy come in and detour you from watching and reporting. You know, no matter what attack comes, it's an attack, is the point. It is an attack. So, hey now, don't dream it's over. Hey now, when the world comes in. Again, family, Jesus is so close. Put worldly things aside. That's all all I can say. And they come to build a wall between us. We know they won't win. The enemy will not win. The war has already been won by the Lord Jesus. And don't let the enemy's fiery darts pull you down. And, prepare to meet the Lord is the bigger, you know, big part of this message. That's what we need to be preparing for, and not making worldly plans, right? Now I'm walking again to the beat of a drum, and I'm counting the steps to the door of your heart. We know Jesus is the door, right? And I believe it's like a love song too. Counting the steps to the door of your heart. only shadows ahead, barely clearing the roof. Get to know the feeling of liberation and release. Our liberation and release, our glorification is coming. We will be liberated from this flesh and released, you know, into eternity. So that's what I gleaned from this. And yeah. Hey now, don't dream it's over. Hey now, when the world comes in, they come to build a wall between us. We know they won't win. Don't let them win. Hey now. Don't let them win. Don't do it. Okay? That's the message. And the confirmation is this. I've prayed again. I said, Lord, have Lulu give me a kiss on the nose. If this is from you, I prayed silently. Lulu did it. And then I prayed silently again. And Lulu jumped down on the floor. And I was like, well, Lord, I'll wait. Because, you know, and I thought, well, if it don't happen, then I'll let it go. Well, she stood on the floor in front of the chair. She was just looking at me for a minute. Then she jumped back up onto my lap and gave me another nose kiss. So she did it twice. It confirms this message. So this is for the watch people. This is for all of the church. And the war is coming, but Jesus is coming. And don't let enemy attacks separate us from our Lord Jesus. And, you know, just don't dream it's over. So it's, I mean, it's a blessing. It's an awesome encouragement for us. And I hope that's what you get out of it. And I'm going to read you a couple of things more to encourage you guys from our family. Allison from Jesus is Lord. I asked God last night if he was coming this month. Then I asked by November at the latest. Then I asked, please just tell me if it's October, and then went to bed. I woke up hearing the numbers 823. It's only related to one verse in the Strong's Concordance. It means, and it relates to only, oh, sorry, it means moment. having some trouble with my eyes. And I'm, you know, dyslexic. I have a touch of dyslexia too, so bear with me. It means moment, and it relates to only one verse, 1 Corinthians 15:52. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. Then when I was taking a nap today, I woke up hearing Yom Teruah. I found out today that the last trumpet in a jubilee year is blown on Yom Kippur and not on Feast of Trumpets. I know the Jews are off on the calendar, but it could turn those feasts into mourning. Yep. You know, they're going to be celebrating atonement real soon. And, you know, that's crossed my mind that maybe that will be what's really turned into mourning, is their fake atonement feast. I just kind of want to be careful now with my words. I don't want to give y'all false hope or anything like that, but I'll just be clear that these are just considerations and not anything that I know. But their feast days will be turned into mourning. I'm just kind of waiting to see what Manchild has found out connected to Roche's dream. And then I can really talk more about our possible exit connections, right? But that is so encouraging, Allison. That is so awesome. Hey now, don't dream. It's over. It's over, guys. Hey now, don't dream. It's over. I mean, thank you, Jesus, so much. When the world comes to build a wall between you, they won't win. So, amen. Praise you, Jesus. I'm so excited. You know, it made me feel so much better, too. And because at first I was like, what in the world is this song doing in my head? And I was like, oh, no. Yeah, that's exactly what it's got to be. You know, I'm one of these people, it takes me, even if I'm up moving around, I still have like fog head, sleepy head going on for a while. I have to get up extra early in the mornings if I got to be somewhere just so I can sit and get woke up. It takes a while. So, yeah, I was like, I know this has got to be the Lord. And immediately, boom, 3, 2, 1 on the clock. So I was like, oh, yeah. And then I went to listen to the song, and I was like, there's definitely a message here. So, awesome. And our sister Mustard Seed said, Oklahoma is a big one. We met a man in April of 2020 who was walking from North Carolina to California with a cross to spread the gospel. He said God told him to pick up his cross and walk and to gather money to build a massive 80-acre disaster relief warehouse in Oklahoma. So far, since 2020, he has walked from North Carolina to Nevada. He is in his 60s, and he amazes me. When I spoke with him, the Holy Spirit radiated off of him. He had to stop his walk because of how hot it got, but he plans to finish it this year. His name is Roger Gates. Keep him in your prayers, and that he is able to finish his walk and stay obedient and healthy. He has one amazing story. Yeah, that is awesome. And I was asking if he's got a YouTube channel. I've seen some videos of another guy doing that with a cross, but I don't know if it's the same one because that guy looked younger. So here's the thing. I'm trying to get as many pieces as I can put together of the safe zones and the danger zones. And then I'll do a video to let you guys know everything I found out. Y'all can grab your notebook and just write it down. It'll kind of save you guys some time. But if you are in a different country, you know, you'll have to see what prophecies have been given over your particular areas, your countries, and do that. Let's see, I think I've got like 18 cities so far that I know that we hit with nukes in states. I know a channel called God's Messenger, he was given a lot of the cities like a year ago. I think I've seen the video. I left him a message today, a text or a comment, sorry, and asked him if he would do another video on it, that I was trying to collect all the information for the Left Behind. Because I didn't know which video it was. But I know there was like 30 or 35 cities that he was given. And he was also, I think, given some in his own country, because he's from England. And I think Liverpool. If I'm not mistaken. I think so. But yeah, he was shown quite a bit. And I'll tell you this. And I loved it too, because he was proven right when the Biden and Trump election was going on. Lee was one of the very few people who came out and said, "The Lord told me Joe Biden's going to win." He was shown in a vision. And Barack Obama was standing behind Biden as if, and Biden handed him a shield. Biden handed Barack a shield, and like it was really him running the country, right? And that Trump wasn't going to win. And everybody came against Lee. And I was in the comments. Y'all know me. And I was saying, listen, I've been following him. He's been on point with everything else. This is true. And, of course, I was attacked, too. I'm like, where's y'all's discernment, man? I mean, do you not listen to anything your gut tells you, which is the Holy Spirit? Or do you just run away with what you want to happen, you know? Sure enough, Biden took the office, did he not, right? So, I mean, I have seen that Lee's on point with a lot of stuff. I said pray on it, and I hope he does the video. Because was shown all of them, if I'm not mistaken. But, if you guys know of any more prophecies that you know for sure are the real deal, please share them with me so I can do more. I want to do a whole video about it and, of course, get all the information in my notebook. I tell you, so far I haven't noticed that my state's going to get hit. Of all the prophecies I have seen that I believe are truly prophetic, West Virginia is a safe zone, but I haven't heard anybody say a particular part of West Virginia, what part would be the safe zone. I do know we are the mountain state, and scripture says to flee to the mountains. We have a lot of mountains, but we are kind of, you know, close to the New Madrid fault line. See, I've got to write that down too. Stay away from Wyoming. Yellowstone is going to go off. The New Madrid is going to split from basically the top of the U.S. to the ocean, split in half. Sarah Hoffman's seen that. And it's, you know, and water is going to come up from the ground too. So there's going to be flooding even in the center of the U.S., from the quakes. It's going to cause all kind. Y'all listened, I'm sure. Y'all know the prophecy. But, I mean, a lot of damage is going to go on. And the Azovina prophecy says only 1/10 of America will be left after the rapture and after the war. 1/10. So it's still getting hit real hard, guys. That's why I want to get these safe zones. But, I mean, I kind of think my state's going to be one of them. I wish I knew for sure. So at least the people here who gets a hold of my notebook would know where to go, if you know. But at least they'll have something to go by, right? And end of all things, our sister shared about parts of Texas being a safe zone. I believe this is true. The Lord brought me and my family to this state 13 years ago and hasn't let me leave, though I never liked it here. He needed me here to prepare the tribulation saints in this area. I prayed supernatural protection over my unbelieving family and their house after the rapture. He's given me peace, so I know He has big plans for them. Yes. The Northern Plains are going to be safe zones too in Alabama. Again, I'm not going to share it all right now, but I am going to dedicate a whole video to it. You might even be able to save it, like screen record it and then put it on a memory card. Maybe if you got a computer, you'll have a lot more memory to do that. Or just, you know, pause it and write everything down. Those books, those Azobina books, if he did a part two on it, like other things that hasn't happened yet, you really don't need the books of all the stuff that has happened, like the part one of Ukraine being invaded. I mean, there's still more to come. It's in progress. But the part about America, if he's got a book just dedicated for the United States, I haven't looked into it, but it's possible. I was thinking that would be a book that they would need. Just the one about the U.S. and whatever other books he has for whatever countries those are. I don't know. Maybe one of you guys might know. See, apparently, I really feel like things are changing. That the Left Behind messages need to come out. And watch people and church. You know, we got an awesome message today. So be encouraged. And, you know, the King, he is in the field. And I'll tell you this. I was starting to doze off. I didn't look at the time or write anything down. It was just a quick little, I don't know, 60-second vision I had. All I seen was exactly what this picture looks like. It was like just a field of green, exactly like that. It looks like a wheat or possible barley that's not ripe yet. And it's just like I didn't see nothing but the green. And I've been thinking on that. Maybe that was like a sign that it wasn't quite ready for harvest yet. Like maybe we weren't at the time quite ready for harvest. I don't know. I haven't really prayed on it, but I did have the vision. I wasn't asleep. I was wide awake. I just had my eyes closed. And that's this picture as what I seen. So it was still green. Or it could just mean the Lord's in the fields. I don't know. But I thought I would share that. And, you know, Roche was sharing something about tabernacles today from Psalm 27. And 27 means beloved. She has 111 for Acts 111 in her subs. And 1-1 at the top there, so like 11-11. And, you know, we know the war is going to happen on 11-11. But Acts 1-11, the Lord's coming, right? And then, yeah, while I was watching it, it turned 3-2-1. So, yeah, that's why we probably all see 11-11 so much. It's been prophesied that the nuclear war will happen on that day on the Gregorian calendar. So, makes sense, right? I know it's got other connections too, but I think Manchild said there's scripture with it, if I'm not mistaken. I wish he'd hurry up and get that video out. I really want to know what's going on. It's a beautiful day here today. It was nasty for the last couple of days. And so far with Zuzu, I screwed up. I said Echo at the end of my last video and I meant Zuzu. It's Zuzu who swallowed the hair tie. And I'm telling you, it was kind of big too. And I don't know why she did that. I mean, how she could even swallow it. So that's why it makes me even extra nervous, family. But I'm going to try to track her litter box trips. And just please pray that it passes. Y'all know these are my kids. And, yeah. And plus, you know, they're special. These little fur critters. They bring confirmations. No, I know it's the Lord doing it. He gets all the glory. But I'm just saying, they have definitely been used by the Lord to save me and bring me close to Him and confirm things. And it's awesome. So be encouraged with this message, family. Let the Holy Spirit speak to you. And yeah, that's about it. I'll try to get this other video done. Again, if you know of any prophecies that could help, let me know. Or anything the Lord shared with you, I would love to hear it and share it. That is so awesome, Allison. And yeah. If any more happens, I'll come and let you know. Sorry that I went long. I was going to try to keep it short. But you know me. I have a hard time doing that. All right, family. God bless you. Oh, if you don't know Jesus, believe the gospel in 1 Corinthians 15, 1-4, that Christ died, was buried, and He rose again on the third day to pay for all of our sins. That is the only way to heaven. It's putting on His righteousness, His blood covering. It's a free gift, Ephesians 2, 8, and 9. A free gift from God, but if you turn it down, you will be judged. Judgment's coming. War is coming. Hell is coming, literally, to earth. Jesus is coming to rapture His church. He truly is. It could be any day. You don't want to wait. Believe today. Be born again of the Spirit. And then you're sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise until the day of redemption. And that is the rapture resurrection. All right, family. Oh, if the calendar. Everybody's got to get on the right calendar. I'm still, you know, following people that are going by this Babylonian calendar. And it's just not going to work out. The only way it can work out is if the feasts are turned into mourning. Otherwise, it doesn't matter. None of the things that the Jews are doing matters unless the Lord is going to use it to send them a sign and turn them into mourning. So the calendar does matter. God's went out of His way to point it out, guys, with all the dreams. And He's still giving them out to show His appointed times, okay? All right. Love you guys. Talk soon.